Well, news of a COVID vaccine couldn't come soon enough for the millions of people whose livelihoods have been affected.
And one couple that Dolly may have special sympathy for is for Sarah Jane and her husband, Andy, who work as a Dolly Parton and Kenny Rogers tribute act.
And as the work has dried up, they've been considering whether or not to swap the rhinestones for a more traditional 9-to-5. Sarah Jane and her husband Andy regularly perform as Dolly Parton and Kenny Rogers.
I have an array of replica costumes that Dolly has worn at some point or other. Lots of bright colours, lots of rhinestones. I do love my white costume, which Dolly wore at Glastonbury many years ago. I just can't wait to get on stage again myself.
But due to the pandemic, like many performers and musicians, they're out of the spotlight and into the office dealing with cancelled shows.
Hastings, Folkestone.
Yeah, both of
Bournemouth.
Those been rescheduled. Really, we've been living on our savings and the furlough that we've received from the government. So it's been tough.
So realistically looking at it, if furlough is to finish in March, you know, and the tickets can't, you know, not selling well, or we can't, you know, really produce the show how we want to and have the tour dates, what we're going to do?
We could run at a loss. We could.
And that's obviously dangerous, isn't it, to run at a loss?
Yeah.
Sarah Jane and Andy have some serious decisions to make.
We can only live in hope that, you know, we get back to performing very, very soon. If not, we're going to have to diversify.
Andy used to be a train driver, so doesn't have any qualms about doing something else. But it's different for Sarah Jane.
I've only ever been an impersonator and performed as Dolly since I was 17. It's all I've ever done.
A poll by the Musicians' Union on the impact of the pandemic on its members found that over a third were considering leaving the industry.
I've been on the government website. I found out that my career choice could possibly be an estate agent. Andy's was a makeup artist, which I thought was really funny. But an estate agent for me, quite interesting.
Keen to investigate whether she'd be any good at it, Sarah Jane is off to meet a local estate agent.
So if the property was under offer and the buyer decided not to proceed with the sale, how would you put that situation to the seller?
I would be as gentle but direct as possible, giving them as much information as I could, and then obviously continue to market the property, I suppose.
And that's key, because sometimes there's an instance where we may be able to save the sale because there wasn't enough information. So there's some things we can do to try and save sales. So now that you know a bit more about the property, what price would you put on it?
I would guesstimate around 975 to £1 million.
Yeah, not too far off at all.
Oh,
not
really?
Too well. We're actually asking 1.1 million, so yeah, almost spot on.
But how easy is it in these uncertain times to just start again when you don't have relevant qualifications? Sarah Jane has a coaching session with business guru and apprentice interviewer Linda Plant to get her take.
What do you think about qualifications, Linda? So, for example, I don't have any qualifications in any of the aspects of my job. How do you think I stand going for a job?
Well, I think, look, I don't have any qualifications either, so that makes two of us. You've got transferable skills and you've got experience. So I would say you could be really, really good at voiceovers or starting singing lessons. That could be online. You know, you could be a PA. You've got your experience in logistics. So that's something you could do.
I love the idea of being a PA.
Of course, it's a saturated market, but there are always opportunities. Yeah, it's difficult, but when is it really ever easy?
So how are you left feeling after today's experience?
I feel confident that if I was to actually go out and look for a job, that I could possibly be in the running for getting a job. And you know, as Dolly says, you can't direct the wind, but you can adjust the sails, and that may be what I'll need to do in the coming future.
Well, just so that you know the whole story, Sarah Jane actually decided to turn down a career as an estate agent, even though she seemed pretty good at it, and has decided to start a company using her music skills alongside being Dolly.
Good enough.
Could be a good job.
I think it's great that she chose to do something with music because that's what she loves. And we said she didn't have a qualification, but she's got guts, and you got to have that in order to do anything. So I think she's going to be okay. But these are hard times for a lot of my other friend musicians and singers not being able to tour. So a lot of people are falling on a lot of hard times. Yeah. I feel very blessed that I've had so many years to make it, and that I can now kind of pull from some of those things that I've done before, like what we're doing now, and do that. But I wish them the best, and I really appreciate them doing Kenny and Dolly so well for so long.